So, you and your team have created a hilarious video that's gone viral. 1 million views on YouTube. Yeah, that is awesome. But how has it impacted your business? If you've gotten 1 million views on YouTube where you've linked your website in the description, you may see a big spike in website traffic. Feels pretty good, right? You've gotten more subscribers too, which is still good. But how many of those 1 million views became customers? How much of that spike in web traffic actually left you their contact information and gotten into your funnel? And those new subscribers, have they converted? We call those 1 million views a vanity metric. We define vanity metrics as metrics that have been designed to impress, but they're not actually indicative of good business performance. Some examples of vanity metrics include social media likes, the number of subscribers in your email lists, blog post views, Facebook fans, or the amount of leads in your sales funnel. These metrics don't accurately reflect the quote-unquote health of your brand. They look good and they feel great. Having the highest social following in your industry looks really good on paper, but it doesn't mean that you necessarily have the highest profit margins in your industry. Measuring your vanity metrics won't provide you with any insights on the performance of your campaigns. But, that being said, vanity metrics aren't inherently evil, nor should you disregard them. Vanity metrics help provide your brand with a little something called social proof. Social proof is what consumers will look to determine how trustworthy you are. When you hear about a brand, where do you head to first? After their website, you'll probably go to their Instagram, their Facebook, their LinkedIn, or check Google, TripAdvisor, or Yelp for reviews. If you're interviewing for a company and you see that they have no activity on LinkedIn, that's probably not going to be a good sign for you. If you want to sign up for a yoga studio membership that claims on their website that they're the biggest studio in the country, but they have no followers on Facebook, you're going to question whether or not they're legit. If a restaurant has horrible reviews on Google and Yelp, are you still going to go? Vanity metrics, like your followers, web hits, or number of app downloads, only show you the current state, but they don't give any insight into how you got to that number of web hits or what you've done right to get that many downloads. Vanity metrics are important for your brand. But for the sake of this lesson, where we're going to focus on how to measure the monetary success of your brand, you'll want to avoid looking to them for actionable information. Let's go through a list of vanity metrics versus actionable metrics right now. A vanity metric, the number of likes on your social media. An actionable metric, how many leads you've gotten through your social media. You're able to measure and track how well your different social media campaigns perform in getting something that directly affects your business. You may have gotten more likes on the pictures of your office dog, but your infographic posts have generated the most link clicks and leads. If you only looked at the likes, you would probably think that the people of Instagram want dogs, which, well, I mean, they do. But when you look at your lead rate, you've found that these informative posts are actually the ones that have the power to grow your business. A vanity metric, the number of subscribers in your email list. An actionable metric, the conversion rate from your email campaigns. Again, you're able to measure and track which of your emails have performed the best in terms of conversions, which will give insight into what emails resonate the most with your subscribers. A vanity metric, how many customers you've acquired. An actionable metric, how much it costs to acquire those customers. If you have 1,500 customers and they each pay $1,000 for your service, you've made $1.5 million. Nice. But if you have to spend $1,500 in marketing, sales, and salaries to get each customer, you're in the hole by $750,000. Not so nice. By measuring the customer acquisition costs, we can see where we need to cut down in order to be profitable. Is it starting to make sense? So, in short, to answer the question to the title of this section, are vanity metrics evil? No, not at all. What's important is to understand that to measure the success of your initiatives, you have to dig deeper into your own data and numbers than just looking at the surface. Let's take a second to do a quick knowledge check question. Which of the following is an actionable metric? A, the likes on an Instagram post. B, the number of leads in a sales funnel. C, your monthly revenue. Or D, your conversion rate. The correct answer here is D, conversion rate. By tracking our conversion rate in our email campaigns or our social media campaigns, we'll be able to analyze which of our emails or social media posts work the best for conversions and optimize our future strategies accordingly.